إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، we have إن شاء الله the class of تفسير from سورة البقرة، سورة number 2. From verse 152. Sheikh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala said in the tafsir of this ayat, رحمه الله، بقوله عز وجل فاذكروني أذكركم، فأمر تعالى بذكره ووعد عليه أفضل جزاء، وهو ذكره لمن ذكره، كما قال تعالى على لسان رسوله: ما ذكرني في نفسي ذكرته في نفسي، وما ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منهم. Have we taken that verse last week? Okay. We didn't take that one. Where did we stop? But did we read the English? طيب. أيوة. وذكر الله تعالى وذكر الله تعالى أفضله ما تواطى عليه القلب واللسان، وهو ذكر الذي يثمر معرفة الله ومحبته وكثرة ثوابه، والذكر هو رأس الشكر، فلهذا أمر به خصوصا، ثم بعده أمر بالشكر عموما، فقال: واشكروا لي، أي على ما أنعمت عليكم بهذه النعم ودفعت عنكم صنوف النقم. والشكر يكون بالقلب إقرارا بالنعم واعترافا، وباللسان ذكرا وثناء، وبالجوارح طاعة لله وانقيادا لأمره واجتنابا لنهيه. فالشكر فيه بقاء النعمة الموجودة وزيادة في النعم المفقودة. قال تعالى: لئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. وفي الاتيان بالأمر بالشكر بعد النعم الدينية من العلم وتزكية الأخلاق والتوفيق للأعمال بيان أنها أكبر نعم، بل هي النعم الحقيقية التي تدوم إذا زال غيرها، وأنه ينبغي لمن وفق العلم أو عمل أن يشكر الله على ذلك ليزيدهم من فضله، وليندفع عنهم الإعجاب فيشتغلوا بالشكر. ولما كان الشكر ضده الكفر نهى عن ضده، فقال: ولا تكفرون. المراد بالكفر ها هنا ما يقابل الشكر، فهو كفر النعم وجحدها وعدم القيام بها. ويحتمل أن يكون المعنى عاما، فيكون الكفر أنواعا كثيرة، أعظمه الكفر بالله، ثم أنواع المعاصي على اختلاف أنواعها وأجناسها من الشرك فما دونه. قال الله عز وجل، الله سبحانه وتعالى said in this ayah, سورة البقرة verse number 152: فاذكروني أذكركم. فاذكروني أذكركم. Therefore remember me, I will remember you. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command to be remembered, to remember, to be remembered. And He promised whoever remembers Him that Allah Azza wa Jal remembers him. Allah commands the believers, rather all men, to remember Him, to mention Him, to say good about Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to attribute Him that which is durable, which is durable for Him, Azza wa Jal, of beautiful names, the high descriptions and attributes, to remember Allah Azza wa Jal in the heart, to remember Allah in the tongue, and to remember Allah in the limbs. الذكر and the best ذكر the mentioning of Allah and remembering Allah is the one is both from the heart and the tongue at the same time. To remember Allah Azza wa Jal has a lot of benefit, including that it makes the heart rest. Ala bi dhikri lahi tatma'innu al-qulub. From the benefit of remembering Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembers you. Sound hadith, whoever remembers Allah by himself, Allah remembers him, Azza wa Jal, by himself. Whoever remembers Allah in a group, Allah mention him, remember in a group better than him. Mention that person in a group better than those he mentioned among them in Allah's name. Washkuru li, Allah said, washkuru li, and be, make shukr, be grateful to me. Being grateful to Allah is from remembering Allah. It has been mentioned separate for the importance of shukr, which is to be thankful to Allah for the blessings He bestowed upon you. Uncountable blessings. Blessings from the religions, religious blessings and worldly benefits. Blessings, uncountable. ولا تكفرون. When Allah commands to be grateful to Him and to thank Him, He forbade the opposite, which is to be ungrateful to Him. And ungratefulness to Allah means to disbelieve in Him, to deny Him or His deen. Also, it means not to use the blessings He bestowed upon you into the causes that pleases Him. So that places Him Azza wa Jal. For instance, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you a wealth, if you use that wealth in haram way, you are not thankful to Allah in the wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you vision. If you watch the haram, the dislike, those things Allah forbade, you are not thankful to Allah for the vision. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you ears to hear with, to listen the haram, the shirk, the falsehood, the music and the like, then you are not thankful to Allah in that blessings. But if you use it into that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes it, then you are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So being thankful to Allah, being grateful to Allah is not just saying alhamdulillah. It's not just saying alhamdulillah. Allah gave me money, alhamdulillah. While using the money into the unlawful ways, oppressing people and the like. So is a word. فَاذْكُرُونِ أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Which one is more important? To remember Allah in your heart and to be aware of what you're saying. يعني to remember Allah in your heart. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, to mention Him. Or just to say that in the tongue while your heart is busy with something else. Naam, it's very clear. Allah doesn't accept the supplication of the one who his heart is not aware. Is at the heart is absent. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give me such and such, protect me from such and such. And the person is really busy with something else. Something else. The heart is not there. What's being considered is the heart. Therefore, if you enter salah and you say you intend to that you are praying asr, that is the intention. But you say to someone next to you that you are praying, for instance, Dhuhr. So, yes, your word, you said you're praying Dhuhr. But you intended that you're praying Asr. Which Salah will be considered? The Asr, whatever you intend. إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالِ بِالنِّيَاتِ. So this is how important is the tongue, the heart. Rather, people do the same actions. the same action, but they get different reward. One punishment and one honoring and reward because of the intention. So to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Azza wa Jal in the tongue, in the heart, and also to use His blessings to the ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Then Allah says subhanahu, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah. Fadhkuruni adhkurkum, therefore remember me by praying, glorifying. I will remember you and be grateful to me for my countless favors on you, and never be ungrateful to me. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah. Shaykh Abdul Rahman rahimahullah ta'ala said, Amara Allah ta'ala al-mu'minin bil-isti'anati ala umurihim al-diniyya wal-dunyawiyya bil-sabri wal-salah. Fal-sabru huwa habsu nafsi wa kafuha ala ma takrah. Al-sabru huwa habsu nafsi wa kafuha ala ma takrah. Fahuwa thalathatu aqsam. Sabruha ala ta'ati Allahi hatta tu'addiha. تؤديها وعن معصية الله حتى تتركها وعلى أقدار الله المؤلمة فلا تتسخطها. فالصبر هو المعونة العظيمة على كل أمر. فلا سبيل لغير الصابر أن يدرك مطلوبه خصوصا الطاعات الشاقة المستمرة، فإنها مفتقرة أشد الافتقار إلى تحمل الصبر وتجرع المرارة الشاقة، فإذا لازم صاحبها الصبر فاز بالنجاح. وإن رده المكروه والمشقة عن الصبر والملازمة عليها لم يدرك شيئا وحصل على الحرمان. وكذلك المعصية التي تشتد دواعي النفس ونوازعها إليها وهي في محل قدرة العبد، فهذه لا يمكن تركها إلا بصبر عظيم وكف لدواعي قلبه ونوازعها لله تعالى، واستعانة بالله على العصمة منها، فإنها من الفتن الكبار. وكذلك البلاء الشاق خصوصا إن استمر، فهذا تضعف معه القوة النفسانية والجسدية ويوجد مقتضاها وهو التسخط، إن لم يقاومها صاحبها بالصبر لله والتوكل عليه واللجأ إليه والافتقار على الدوام. فعلمت أن الصبر محتاج إليه العبد، بل مضطر في كل حالة من أحواله، فلهذا أمر الله تعالى به وأخبر أنه مع الصابرين، أي مع من كان الصبر له خلقا وصفة وملكة بمعونته وتوفيقه وتسديده. فهانت عليهم بذلك المشاق والمكاره، وسهل عليهم كل عظيم، وزالت عنهم كل صعوبة. وهذه معية خاصة تقتضي محبته ومعونته ونصره وقربه، وهذه منقبة عظيمة للصابرين. فلو لم يكن للصابرين فضيلة إلا أنهم فازوا بهذه المعية من الله لكفى بها فضلا وشرفا. وأما المعية العامة فهي معية العلم والقدرة، كما في قوله تعالى وهو معكم أينما كنتم، وهذه عامة للخلق. وأمر تعالى بالاستعانة بالصلاة لأن الصلاة هي عماد الدين ونور المؤمنين، وهي الصلة بين العبد وبين ربه. فإذا كان صلاة العبد صلاة كاملة مجتمعا فيها ما يلزم فيها وما يسن، وحصل فيها حضور القلب الذي هو إليها هو لبها، وحصل فيها حضور القلب الذي هو لبها، فصار العبد إذا دخل فيها استشعر دخوله على ربه ووقوفه بين يديه موقف العبد الخادم المتأدب، مستحضرا لكل ما يقوله وما يفعله، مستغرقا بمناجات ربه ودعائه، لا جرم أن هذه الصلاة من أكبر المعونة على جميع الأمور. فإن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر، ولأن هذا الحضور الذي يكون في الصلاة يوجب للعبد في قلبه وصفا وداعيا بدعوة يدعوه إلى امتثال أوامر ربه واجتناب نواهيه. هذه الصلاة التي أمر الله أن نستعين بها على كل شيء. الله سبحانه وتعالى said in the next ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, oh you who believe, استعينوا بالصبر, seek help in patience. He seek help in patience. والصلاة and الصلاة, the prayer in prayer. Seek help in patience and in prayer. إن الله مع الصابرين. Truly Allah is with those who are الصابرين, the patients. In this verse, Allah commands the believers. Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, O you who believe. Allah is not calling the non-Muslims. In this verse, Allah is addressing in this verse the believers. Those who believe in Allah subhanahu and believe in His ayat, verses. Allah called them with the description of belief. ومقتضى الإيمان الاستجابة لأمر الله. And if the person truly believes in Allah and is in the verse of Allah, then he will respond the call of Allah Azza wa Jal. He will answer. Therefore, Sahabi al-Jalil ibn Mas'ud used to say, what means, if you hear Allah saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, in the Quran, he said, be attention to it. Listen to it. Because it's either good thing you be in command, or it is evil thing you be in forbidden. Always in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Either Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is calling us to do something good, or He Subhanahu wa Ta'ala prohibiting something bad. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu. So when we hear Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, we should be careful and wait what Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is saying to us, especially when He honors us by calling us with the description Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu. And based on how strong your iman is or weak, your response is going to be. If you are very strong in iman, you will completely submit yourself into Allah's command subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the iman is weak, then based on that, the answer in the call of Allah is going to be weak. If there is no iman, then no answer. So it's a place the person to test himself. How strong your iman is, or how weak is. How do you respond when Allah commands, subhanahu, when His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commands? So here Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, O you who believe, استعينوا بالصبر, seek help in patience. Seek help in patience. So the sabr is from the things you need to use as aid and help and support to reach your goal. To reach your goal, your worldly goals or your religious goals, use the sabr, the patience to get it. Sheikh Sa'd rahimahullah ta'ala said something meaning the sabr, patience, is three types. When Allah commands us to have sabr, to be patient. By the way, in sabr هو حبس النفس على ما تكره من الخير والطاعة. The patience is to withhold the soul on that which is good, to hold it to the good, keep it attached to the good. It's like habs, it's like jail. So the Sheikh said the sabr is three types. To have patience by doing the commands of Allah. It needs sabr. Anyone who has no sabr, patience cannot continue praying five prayer. He can't. She can't. Can't fast Ramadan. Can't do righteous deeds without sabr. The second type of sabr, patience, or the second position that person is in need of sabr, is when it comes to desires. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibits something, to leave it for the sake of Allah, it needs sabr, especially if what calls you to do that desire is there. It really needs a big sabr, patience, withholding the soul. You need sabr. Someone who used to smoke and he wants to quit the smoking, he needs to have sabr. Based on how much he has desire for smoking. Some people, they are strong, they are very addicted to it. They need more sabr. More sabr. And just an example, any desire, any lusts, any haram things which the soul calls us to do, we have to have sabr to leave it. Patience. Holding, withholding. يعني keeping the soul from the haram. Making mujahada, turning the hearts away from that. Changing the way. Subhanallah. In a way, the sahaba, they used to reach to advise one another. The person he's talking to himself. Oh soul, fear Allah. Like happened in the battle of Mu'ta. يعني the sahabi, when he saw what يعني in the battlefield, he's talking to himself. Saul, get يعني obey your Lord. The person is talking to himself to help himself be upon sabr and patience. He's advising himself, not just in the, he's talking. Fear Allah, O Saul. Don't do this. If you do this, this is the consequence. It means this person is struggling. And subhanallah, Allah promised, subhanah, whoever struggle in his cause, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide him to the haq. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ صُبُولَنَا. Don't ever say, you can't be good. No, you are not that type of people who can live haram. No, you don't repent, you can't. People are different than you. You have a strong shaitan. You can't repent. Don't ever accept this whispering from your enemy, shaitan. Don't say the like of you can never do this. He can never continuously, constantly establish the prayers. You can't make it. You try several times, you can't make it. La. Never accept that. Don't ever say, I can't be patient with difficulty and calamity. I know myself. La. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ صُبُولَنَا. Allah, I swear that whoever struggles in his cause, he tries, never give up, he will make it. Need sabr. The third type of patience is as-sabru ala aqdari Allah al-mu'lima. To be patient on the painful calamities. Painful calamities, very severe calamities take place, and it must take place. As long as you are in a worldly life, it is the way of Allah to have some difficulties, afflictions. If it's not today, tomorrow, it must take place. This is the way of Allah. No human being ever come this worldly life, live, and he never have a problem. It never happened. He had. Rather, when we born, by the time we born, we start crying. Go to the hospital and see when the child born. The first time he comes to the worldly life, crying, screaming. Something is bothering. Must accept who? Who didn't cry? Prophet Isa and who? And his mother, Maria. So this is riya haqqan. Shaitan is one who touching the person, the baby, right there yelling. Then the rest of the life, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ. This is the way of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So every day is not going to be, every time, every minute, it will not going to be the way you like it. So what should we have? Allah command us to have sabr in this. Yes, you don't have money now, don't steal. Because you don't have enough money, don't cheat people. Have sabr. Have sabr, even if you don't eat whole day. Naam. Yes, you need to get married, you don't have the right person. Have sabr. وليستعفف. Yes, you have a desire for haram, have sabr. It needs sabr. Difficult hardships, have sabr. يعني don't say bad thing. Don't have bad feeling in your heart and mad and why me, what the kuffar say. The people who are not accepting the decree of Allah say, why me, why this? If I would have, if I wouldn't, if I couldn't. Don't do all this. Allah decree. It must take place. These are the three ways, the three times the person needs to have sabr. When he has desire against the commands of Allah, he needs to have patience to withhold himself, to stop it. حُفَّتِ النَّارُ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. Hellfire was surrounded with desires. This is the haqq. In Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim. Hellfire was surrounded with desires and lusts. Whoever goes after his desire lust must end to hellfire. This is the path to it. On the other hand, حُفَّتِ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِهِ. Paradise was surrounded with dislikings. So someone who says he wants to have freedom, he's here in America, he's free. He can do what he wants. He's not anymore under age, young. He can do what he wants. Yes, he's free. You can't tell him what he needs to do, what he needs to do. Someone who looking for that this type of freedom, which means to fulfill his desire, he's clearly heading to hellfire. No other means. Because Prophet ﷺ said, كُلُّ أُمَّةِ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَبَى. قَالُوا وَمَنْ يَأْبَى يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. قَالَ مَنْ أَطَاعَنِي دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ أَبَى. Prophet ﷺ said, all my ummah will enter paradise except who refuses. Companions said, who refuses, O the Messenger, to enter paradise? He said, whoever obeys me. Naam, whoever obeys me enters Jannah. And whoever disobeys me, refuse the paradise. So disobeying the Messenger and doing sin means refusing and rejecting paradise. That's what it means. So someone doing haram, disobeying Allah, and at the same time expecting to enter Jannah, he's in deception. Paradise has a way, has a means, and hellfire has a means. Whoever takes the path of hellfire, it leads to hellfire. Whoever takes the path of Jannah, it leads to Jannah. Al-Muhim, sabr is not easy. Therefore, is the whole religion. Subhanallah, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala knows His creation. Shaykh Uthaymeen Rahimahullah mentioned that the wisdom of different acts of worship, like fasting, you have to refrain from eating and drinking and your desires. Zakah, you have to spend your money. Salah, you have to physically and spiritually and pray. Shaykh Uthaymeen said, some people may be easy to them to give it, to spend. It's very generous. And it's known people are not the same. People, when it comes to giving, are not the same. Wallahi, they are not the same. Some people, they don't have anything. He may have $10. Someone asks that $10. He was going to take it to his family. Some of them is very simple to give $10 to the poor, to go back with nothing. It's very simple. Some people, they have thousands of dollars. Maybe they already check how much next 5 years, they have already their income there. It's very hard on them to spend $10. People are different. In a way, they mention some people, they don't use their own wealth for themselves, let alone for someone else. So people, they do, they take them to the restaurants, eat. When this person eat, they say, pay your money, you're the one who eat. Otherwise, they say he will not eat. And it's a reality. Some people, they die with a big wealth. They didn't use it. People are different. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests people with the money, with the fasting from eating and drinking and desire, with ماذا حج and traveling for Allah, the prayer. So to test the one who is following desires, whatever goes along with his desire, he doing it. Whatever is against his desire, he leave it, or whoever doing whatever pleases Allah. Yeah, it's not easy for him to spend his money, but he's doing it for the sake of Allah. It's not easy for him to fast 12 hours maybe or more, but he is doing for the sake of Allah. It's not easy for him to pray 5 prayers a day, but he's doing for the sake of Allah. This is the one who following Allah's commands. Unlike someone who does, he takes from religion what he desires. And he leaves what he has no desire, what is not يعني, convenient with him. So Allah commands to have sabr. Therefore Allah said, وَاللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Indeed Allah is with الصابرين. Allah is with you. What's the meaning? Allah is with you. Scholars, they said there is 2 types of ma'iyya, of Allah being with his creation, 2 types. One type is general ma'iyya. Allah is with everyone, which means in his knowledge and power, al-ilm wal-qudra. Allah is with all his creation in knowledge and in power, in controlling, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is with them. And second type of Allah being with his creation is ma'iyyatu ta'yid, is the ma'iyya, is Allah is being with this creation by supporting. Allah said, idhaba, Allah said to Prophet Musa and Harun, fa'atiya, was the ayah before, innani ma'akuma asma'u wa ara, was the beginning of that ayah. Innani ma'akuma asma'u wa ara. Na'am. بارك الله فيك الله يحفظكما يا زيد عكاشة. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, قال لا تخافا, أو Prophet موسى and هارون, don't fear from فرعون. Why? إنني معكما, I am with you. أسمع وأرى, I hear and I see. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى is being with Prophet Musa and Harun means in support and assist, that Fir'aun cannot reach them with difficulty. He can't. Fir'aun try all the means to harm Prophet Musa alayhi salam, to kill him. All, but he can't. Because Allah is with Prophet Musa and Harun in support and help and assisting. إذ يقول لصاحبي لا تحزن إن الله معنا. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Abu Bakr Siddiq, Abu Bakr Siddiq رضي الله عنه, in the cave, don't grieve Abu Bakr. إن الله معنا, Allah is with us. What it means? What type of being with? يعني closeness. What type of closeness? Jazakallahu khair. What type of closeness? The closeness of supporting and assisting. But the other type, the closest of knowledge and power and controlling, is Allah is with all his creation. مَا يَكُونُ مِنْ نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُ. There are no 3 people who have in secret gathering. Allah is the 4th. وَلَا خَمْسَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ سَادِسُ. Nor are there 5, Allah is the 6th. وَلَا أَدْنَى مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَلَا أَكْثَرُ إِلَّا هُوَ مَعَهُمْ أَيْنَ مَا كَانُ. ثم ينبئهم بما عملوا يوم القيامة. إن الله بكل شيء عليم. And Allah started with ayah, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهِ. So in this verse, Allah mentioned that three, any three who have secret gathering, Allah is the fourth. The fourth, Allah is the fifth. The fifth, Allah is the sixth. More, Allah is with them. Less than that number, two, one, Allah is with them. What is the meaning of Allah is being with them? Allah mentioned in the beginning of the ayah, at the end of the ayah. Allah starts with the verse, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهِ أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهِ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Don't you know that Allah, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهِ يَعْلَمْ, that Allah knows whatsoever in the heaven, whatsoever on the earth. At the end of the same verse, إِنَّ اللَّهِ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. Allah is all knowledgeable to everything. Allah knows everything. So this is two ma'iyah. So in this ayah, when Allah says, Wallahu ma, inna Allah ma'a sabirin, truly Allah is with those who have sabr, with the patience. Who type of closeness Allah here is talking about, subhanah? The closeness of support and aid and help. Na'am. So the Sheikh Sa'di said what it means. If there wouldn't be any benefit for the sabr, then Allah is being with you, Allah helping you, Allah assisting you, Allah aiding you, he said it would have been enough. Subhanallah. Sabr. It's not easy. You see at the beginning of Ramadan, normally every year almost, first 5 days, 6 days, almost the masjid is packed up. A lot of people. Alhamdulillah. Then after 7 days or 10 days, normally. Every year, it's not 1 year, it's not one area. Everywhere. Then you may see them last week the most, or last 4 nights of the month. Where people are in the middle tense. Every year is because, يعني ما في صبر. No patience to continue whole month to act the same way. Where some of the Salaf Salih, they wish that to be the whole year. Rather, they do every year. Every night, some of the Salaf Salih, every night, they pray 11 rak'ah. Ramadan, to them, they pray less because of the jama'ah. When they are by themselves, they pray long, make long location, recitation. People are different. And we're struggling with the first week then. And there are even people who don't even attend the first week. Some people, they even don't fast Ramadan. They can't be patient. So sabr is all the religion. Yani all the religion. Some people, that, alhamdulillah, can be patient in, but when it comes to calamity and musibah, yani they lost their wealth, their children, their car, you may see them different. Where is the person with the strong iman now has questions even upon his religion? Why this happened to me? Why this? Why this? لعدم الصبر عند البلاء. صلى الله السلامة والعافية. There is a question. The sabr and being patient, is it something I can learn? I can train myself so I can get it, or the person born with it? There is some hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said from hadith Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, in the hadith, وَمَنْ يَسْتَعْفِفْ يُعِفُّهُ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يَسْتَغْنِي يُغْنِهِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهِ وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدٌ عَطَاءً خَيْرًا وَأَوْسَعَ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. In this hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهُ. Whoever makes himself have sabr, he tries, he causes himself to have sabr, صَبَّرَهُ اللَّهُ. Allah gives him the sabr. Allah gives him the patience. يعني whoever tries, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him. And before the hadith, in the hadith, وَمَنْ يَسْتَغْنِ يُغْنِهِ اللَّهُ. Whoever causes himself to be sufficient, He is not really غني. He is not sufficient. He is in need of, but he tries not to show, not to ask. In a way, some people, they think that this one is a rich person. يحسبهم الجاهل أغنياء. The ignorant person thinks this one is wealthy. لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. He is really poor, but he doesn't show it. He hides that from people. In a way, they consider wealthy. What will he get? يغنيه الله. One day, Allah will make him rich, this person. ومن يستعفف يعفه الله. So in this hadith that we can learn the sabr. We can learn to have sabr from haram. To have sabr on the good. To have sabr on the calamity and difficulties. Because Prophet Muhammad mentioned that. After that, we shouldn't say, I can't have sabr. I can't. Don't say this. Don't please your shaitan, your enemy. يعني. Then the Prophet said, complete the hadith with this. وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدٌ عَطَاءً خَيْرًا وَأَوْسَعَ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. Nobody is ever given a gift better and more larger than the patience. You are never given anything more better and bigger, larger than a sabr. To have sabr. Subhanallah. Some people, because they don't have sabr, عندهم حرص. What's حرص in English? نعم? Yes? Enthusiasm. Barakallah. A strong desire to reach this. They don't have sabr, it leads them to steal, it leads them, subhanallah, to have. Even somebody oppress you. Somebody oppress you. You need to have sabr, not to oppress you. You need to have sabr. Some people, they do calamity. Naam. Therefore, it's legislated. A Muslim to ask is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him sabr. To have patience. Mada from committing sin. To have patience on doing the good. And to have patience in the difficult and hardships. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدنيا سجن المؤمن. وَجَنَّةُ الْكَافِرِ. The worldly life is what? The sijn. What is sijn? The prison of the believer. Is the prison of the believer. وَجَنَّةُ الْكَافِرِ. And the paradise of the disbeliever. How? One of the Jewish saw that great noble scholar, Ibn Hajar Asqalani, is the one who explained. Rather, is the best explanation of Sahih al-Bukhari we have today, which is complete. It's called Ibn Hajar Asqalani, rahimahullah. He was very honored with the knowledge Allah gave him. He also used to be a judge in Egypt. And they used to apply the Sharia. Courts, nothing else. Not like today. In many Muslim lands, when you come to the court, is John Smith say this one. Frankfurt said this one, code number 5, code number 2, underline, mafi. Back days, this is what Allah said in this ayah, Prophet said in this ayah, and the like. So the judge had a high position. Naam. So he saw, this Jewish man saw Ibn Hajar Asqalani with around him those soldiers or those people. He said, oh, Ibn Hajar, your messenger said, وسلم, the worldly life is the sijin, is the prison of the believer and the paradise of the disbeliever. He said, what sijin, what prison are you in? And what paradise am I in? Khana Abdurrahim, what could you answer? Somebody ask you. Yes. These sound hadith. Alhamdulillah, that the Jewish man asked the question, Ibn Hajar Asqalani. He asked Alim. Those Allah grant them knowledge. Naam, he said, the believer in this worldly life, he is in prison considering the Jannah, the paradise, he will enter. So, no matter how blessed, worldly blessed you are in this worldly life, you are a believer, you are really in a prison, in a jail, comparing to the paradise which is waiting you. وفيها ما تشتهيه أنفسهم in the paradise, whatsoever your soul desires. لا مقطوعة ولا ممنوعة. It's not being stopped and it's not being rejected. So in the Akhirah, there is no you can't do this one, don't do this one, don't look here, don't say this one, don't dress this way, don't go this place, don't eat this one. Whatever you like, do it. There's no doubt a Muslim is in a jail, in a prison in that way. Habs. And he said, you, the disbeliever, he's in a paradise in this world, comparing what's waiting him of hellfire. Was waiting of hellfire. Now he's in this world life, he's a paradise, no doubt. Someone will go into hellfire, worldly life is paradise for him. Al-Muhim, the point is, a Muslim, he's in a prison, meaning he's obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can't go where he desires. He can't eat any food. He can't dress any way. He can't talk any way. He can't listen everything. He can't watch everything. La, everything. He has to look what Allah likes and he does it, what Allah dislikes, and he leaves it. But these things, which is a prison and withholding the soul from haram and keeping it upon haq, being patient and difficult and afflictions and calamities, is the only way to Jannah, paradise. Al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. The reward is based on the actions. In this worldly life, when you left your desire for the sake of Allah, Allah set free your desire in the hereafter. On the other hand, when somebody go after his desire in this worldly life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says them to the Akhirah, اصبروا أو لا تصبروا. Have patience or don't have patience. سواءٌ عليكم. It is the same to you. إنما تجزون ما كنتم تعملون. You only be rewarded based on what you used to do it. So, a Muslim to have sabr, to have patience from committing sin. Even yes, you have desire for it, you like it, نعم, you feel enjoyment, but remember, يعني you need to have sabr to enter Jannah. On the other hand, to wake up for Fajr prayer or for Salawat, to be with the good Muslims, to avoid the bad friends, to be with the good people, to obey the parents in good, to respect them, to put happiness in their heart, you need to have sabr. Sometimes parents may call you to something you have no desire, rather you don't want to even do it. You need to have sabr to say, Subhanallah, Astaghfirullah, Allah commanded me to do that. Regardless how I feel, I have to obey my mother, I have to obey my father. Any plan you have, any wrong plan you have, to go with barfer, to have fun, you quit. Who can do this without sabr? Through that sabr, you enter Jannah. Yes, a calamity take place, your house get burned, your car have a problem. Especially Shaykh Sa'di says, when the problem is continuous, it's easy when it happens one day. But if it keep on, the sickness you have, the disease you have is continuous. Not one day, it's not one year even. This need more patience. نسأل الله الكريم بأسماء الحسنى وصفات العلى أن يمن علينا الصبر على الطاعة والصبر عن المعاصي والصبر على أقدار الله. والله أعلم، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.